The population growth in the northern and central parts of the island is causing overcrowding issues in Guam's public high schools. According to Deputy Superintendent Rob Millay, overall enrollment has stayed the same throughout the Department of Education's elementary and middle schools, but DOE has seen an increase of about 600 high school students over the last 3 years, making space tighter in northern and central high schools.
What we're trying to do is drill down the data to find out exactly what's going on. Are the numbers in high school because not enough students aren't earning their credits to graduate on time? Is that one of the reasons? Which it could be. And we've got to really be on top of that and look at it a little closer. We've had the data, and we've seen the data, but we haven't really dug into the data to find out what the specific reasons are.
But DOE is also finding that as more housing developments are built in the central and northern parts of the island, enrollment has grown as well. George Washington High School has been at its maximum capacity for several years, but Millay says that's not the school with the fastest growing population.
Well, right now, the one that's most affected would be JFK.
The new facility at John F. Kennedy High School can handle the growing central population, but with 200 new students this school year alone, there is a need for more teachers.
We have a large freshman class, but we also have other, it's all the other classes as well. Students, in fact, today, I had one student in my office coming in from another high school, transferring in because she now lives in the JFK district.
JFK Assistant Principal Asher D. Rossetti says school administrators have been working closely with the superintendent's office to determine whether to transfer students to the school to fill the needs or have teachers volunteer to teach additional classes.
It's been a previous practice that teachers who volunteer to teach to, you know, minimize the overcrowding are compensated. So we're looking at all of our resources to see how we can address these needs, because of course quality instruction is really what we're after.
But with growth in the central and north likely to continue,
does that give an argument for trying to build a school in the central? People have been talking about it for years.
Well, we could certainly make the argument for that, and we could also certainly make an argument for reestablishing attendance areas and living with the existing structures that we have. So all of those things are going to have to be weighed in on so that we can have manageable schools with manageable classes so that, again, the learning process is protected and is functioning at its full ability.
Betsy Brown, PNC News.